boxes come out or are already out. So if you have one of those, congratulations. If not, probably gonna have to wait to like Christmas, like the rest of us. So I know I don't have one, but I thought I'd bring out the controller for a little bit of extra controller tingles for you guys. So yeah, in today's video, we are going to be talking about some trades. Yes, wow, very surprising, but not just any trades. Since the draft is about a week away, we are going to be talking about trades that should, could happen in this year's NBA draft. Very exciting. There already been a lot of rumors just came out very recently about a couple teams, so we're going to be talking about. players need depth. They need they need not a lot of money spent. So if you can get a rookie on a rookie contract who is a top 10-ish, 15-ish pick who can play right now, I think that's what you need for sure. So I really like the idea of them trading down in this year's draft and getting another role player back for that. Do I like the idea of just trading for Blake Griffin? No. It's the idea of this, like, making Blake Griffin their center, or Draymond getting traded, or Draymond being the five. I'm not sure why they would do this trade. Sure, I think Blake definitely needs to leave Detroit so bad. He needs to get out of there. He needs to go on, like, a contending team. He needs to, you know, start putting staples into his name, because Blake Griffin's obviously, you know, one of the most popular players in this little 2000s generation, you know, 2010s generation. Obviously been on really great teams, really, really, really super hyped up player, but just hasn't been there team accomplishment wise. You know, obviously being on the LA Clippers, didn't make the hump, and it really is really sad. So I think it may be getting on a team. I know it keeps spouting these same teams out, but these are the teams that are in the title runnings. Like, I don't know. If you could put them on, like, the Bucks, that'd be dope. If you could put them on, oh, like, the Celtics would be amazing. But I think him on the Warriors would be, it'd be clashing. I don't like that. I think Draymond should just start a power forward. They need a center, and they need a small forward. So whatever they can get out of that, they can get out of that. So yeah, I don't really like this trade at all, in my opinion. Oh, here we go, ladies and gentlemen. This is the pretty much the biggest news apparently that has come out in recent sort of a time, as this video is getting filmed. It's the interest of apparently the Phoenix Suns and Oklahoma City Thunder, and the Oklahoma City Thunder trading Chris Paul to the Suns. That is very interesting. One of the trade sort of, not sort of rumors, or like the trade that is being rumored that's going to happen, but just a trade for that to happen, is the Phoenix Suns receive Chris Paul in exchange for Ricky Rubio. So you get the, I guess, I'm assuming a backup point guard, because I'm assuming that Dennis Schroeder would just take the starting role, or maybe even just Shea will just start, and then you maybe move Rubio, or you move Dennis Schroeder. Also, Kelly Oubre Jr. So you get Rubio, Kelly Oubre Jr. So you get a starting three, which they definitely need in OKC. And then you get the Phoenix Suns pick. So I think it's number 10. So you get a top 10 pick, Ricky Rubio and Kelly Oubre Jr. for Chris Paul. Okay, so we're looking at this at the Phoenix Suns. I say, oh man, do I do this trade? I really like the idea of the Suns just building a really super deep team and just sort of making a run in like 2-3 years, but I don't think Devin Booker wants to wait another like 2-ish years to like make a really good push. So they're going to accelerate that with getting Chris Paul. Obviously an old player. We saw him last year be really good for the Thunder. They're going to sort of try to recreate that same energy with the Phoenix Suns. Will it work? I mean, the Suns are arguably, well, I would say they are a better team than a CP3-less Oklahoma City Thunder. So I'm going to say I would do it. If I'm the Suns, I'm doing, I guess, whatever it takes to make Devin Booker happy. And if Devin Booker wants to make the playoffs now, you get Devin Booker in the playoffs. And I think this will definitely help it out. OKC. Yes, I'm doing this trade. You get a top 10 pick. Again, you can get maybe a new power forward, which would be really nice for you guys. You have Shea at the point. Maybe you could pick up another two guard. That'd be really cool. Or I would say maybe a power forward would probably be their best interest. Maybe like a Precious or Onyeka. If you can somehow very slim chance, getting one of those big time big players, I think that'd be awesome. Then you get Kelly Oubre Jr. He can be your starting small forward for, you know, the future. So that's really good. That's really dope. So if I'm the Phoenix Suns, I'm doing this. trade. If I'm OKC, I'm doing this trade. I don't see why not. I think this is works out for both teams, honestly. Oh, this is definitely, well, it's not a new one, but it's definitely one I haven't seen in like a NBA draft trade scenario. But we have here a trade scenario between the Boston Celtics and the Utah Jazz. Wow. In this trade scenario, the Boston Celtics get Rudy Gobert. That's definitely what Boston needs for sure, is better defense. Ed Davis, pretty decent backup center. And Mieyoni. Never heard that player before, no offense, but and then the Utah Jazz get Gordon Hayward, Daniel Tice, the 14th pick, the 26th pick, and a future first round pick. That's pretty crazy. So for Rudy Gobert, you get Gordon Hayward, Daniel Tice, and three first round picks. That's pretty hefty. That's a pretty hefty price. Boston in this trade scenario, they're first. Of course, you want Rudy Gobert. You're giving up a lot to get a better upgraded center. Having to battle teams with you know, Joel Embiid in the East, and having just juggernaut players like a Giannis is very terrifying. And you have Kevin Durant coming back, and you know, a lot of teams are very, very, very much getting better. The Celtics are good, but have they been getting better? They're better than they were like 3 years ago, but they've been pretty stagnant since then. I think a humongous upgrade would, no offense to Daniel Tice, would be getting a better starting center. Could Rudy Gobert be that? Absolutely. Could they maybe find that in something a little bit cheaper? Well, not cheaper, but easier to get, like a Drummond or a Clint Capella? I think yes. But you can get, you know, the mother load of Rudy Gobert. Yes, obviously you get him. But if I'm Utah, oh my god, no. No, 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 no. I am not doing this deal whatsoever. First off, I'm not breaking out Donovan Mitchell and Rudy Gobert yet, unless one of them says, I am not staying here. If he's here, then you trade. If they can work it out, you do, because you have a godly defensive center in Rudy Gobert who can actually put up pretty good stats, you know, 15 points, 15 rebounds, you know, a couple blocks, you know, very good paint presence, which is really good. They're not just like padded stats or anything like that. So if you can keep that with Donovan Mitchell, I think that's a perfect duo. You're not going to give that away for just a, no offense, and a knocking on wood for this guy, a broken down Gordon Hayward player who you've already seen their best of. He's not going to get any better. You get Daniel Tice, who is a good role player, can be a starter, I guess. We see that in Boston, but you wouldn't want him to be your starter. You get the three first round picks, so, and that's what's very interesting. Can you snipe another sort of Donovan Mitchell-esque type of player at the 14th pick? You get a 26th pick, which maybe more like a role player. And then you get a future first round pick, which could, again, turn into something. You never know. So, again, if I'm Boston, I am 100% trying to find an upgraded center. But, I mean, take a shot at Rudy Gobert, sure. If you can, go for it. But if I'm Utah, I'm definitely not doing this trade. This is just, it's not enough. It's definitely not enough. If I would need another all-star-esque type of player to trade for Rudy Gobert, and obviously Gordon Hayward isn't that, even though him and Tice, good players, three first-round picks, that's good, but I'm assuming that Utah wants to, like, make a playoff push now, not in the future. Oh, and also, another trade offer for the second pick of the Golden State Warriors, we're probably going to be talking about that a lot, is the Suns and Warriors. I think we've talked about this before, actually, is the second pick of the Golden State Warriors going to the Phoenix Suns for Kelly Oubre Jr. and the 10th pick. Again, I really like the idea of the Warriors going down in the draft and getting a good player in return plus a pick. They need that pick. They need extra role players on their team. So if they can do this trade, I think this is awesome. Sure, it's not as like good, I guess, as the Blake Griffin trade, because Blake Griffin, Kelly Oubre, I guess you could say Blake Griffin is a better player you know, one-on-one. And then obviously the seventh pick is a higher pick than the 10th pick, so it'd be better. But fit-wise, I think this is perfect. Maybe it'd be nice if you could just do a straight-up trade of Wiggins and Oubre. I don't know how their contracts match up. I think you might have to throw in some more money in for the Suns because I think Wiggins makes a lot more. But I really like this trade. I think it's nice. You trade down, you get Oubre, so you get your starting small forward with Oubre. You get a top 10 pick again with the Blake Griffin trade. I think there's just like 7 or something like that, but the Suns have 10th. You get a top 10 player in the draft. Again, you can get, I don't know. What is the thing that they need? They kind of just need any bench player, so that any good, I think the best possible player at that current time, they just pick up. Like a Sadiq Bey, Cole Anthony, a Precious, or anyone at that certain point in time, I think that'd be perfect for them. And then for Wiggins, you trade him for a center. So maybe you trade him to like the Cavs for Andre Drummond, or again, Clint Capella, Vucevic. You try to find some sort of starting center you can pick up for Andrew Wiggins. I think that'd be perfect. I think that's a perfect idea. Sure, the second pick is very valuable. You know, I've actually heard that a lot of teams are not high on Anthony. I've seen headlines of that a lot on Twitter and Bleacher Report and ESPN, and apparently he's not doing so hot on sort of whether it's the interviews or training sessions. I'm not sure, teams aren't that high on him, but a lot of teams are very high on LaMelo Ball. So you're going to get teams like, again, Detroit, maybe even Cleveland, some other teams that are needing a point guard, maybe even Charlotte, trading up to get that number one spot. So, apparently LaMelo is doing really good on whether it's, you know, LaVar, he happened during his interviews with the teams, or he's just really balling out during these press conferences. But I don't think Anthony Edwards is going to go number one anymore. It's been reported, it keeps getting reported that teams aren't high on him. So that's definitely pretty crazy if LaMelo goes, you know, one, and then at the two spot, you can get Anthony Edwards. He can be the starting shooting guard. And then you get Clay at the three. That's also really good. That's a really good future setup with Anthony Edwards. That's very interesting. But the Warriors can definitely win another championship in the next 2-3 years. And I think trading it, get a ready now player like Kelly Bridge Jr., who can average 15 to 20 points per game, pretty decent, you know, score on his own, corner three shooter, plus a top 10 player, again, a rookie who can come off the bench for the next couple years, develop really well, be a good role player for cheap. I think it's probably the better option. And then again, trade Wiggins, get a good center, fill out your starting lineup, and hopefully pick up some free agencies. And free agency, I think free agency starts at the end of November, and then the season starts, and I think it was voted on that it starts December 22nd, so we're going to have a lot of basketball content coming out soon, so hopefully you guys are ready for that. Definitely still looking at some different ones. I don't know if I should say this one, but I guess I will anyways. Obviously, the big trade that everyone wants to see on draft night is obviously Devin Booker getting traded to the Timberwolves for the number one pick. I think that can definitely happen. This trade scenario has Devin Booker going to the Minnesota Timberwolves for, wow, that's a lot, Jared Culver, James Johnson, Jared Vanderbilt, the first pick, and the 17th pick for Devin Booker. That's a pretty hefty load. I get it, you have the matchup contracts and stuff, and Devin Booker is obviously making like $25-27 million, somewhere around there. So James Johnson's obviously the contract guy there. But giving up Jarrett Culver and the first and the 17th, like, man, that is a lot. And then next year, you don't have your first pick. Your first pick is with the Warriors. Your first round pick is with the Warriors. So you're basically giving up your next 2 years of a good rebuild that you guys are going on right now with Cat and D'Lo, Jarrett Culver, Josh Okogie. It's going pretty well right now. You're going to give that up for Devin Booker, a two-guard that plays a lot like your point guard. Is he better? Head and shoulders above him. sucks that they also have to give up their 17th pick. And that really makes me upset. I would rather them maybe just give up like another future first down the line instead of giving up both these picks. I think that's what I would do if I could take out the 17th pick and then put in a different future draft pick. I would do that, and then I would do it because they still need depth. They need a team. They can't just play three players. Obviously, that's the best. Is that the best three players in the NBA together? I'm trying to think. I mean, maybe. That's maybe the best three players together in the NBA. Talent-wise, obviously not play-wise and things like that. Because LeBron and AD and an eraser is probably the best trio in the NBA. But yeah, that's awesome. That'd be really cool. I'm telling you guys, this draft is going to be a lot of fun, and I hope it is. Just totally, absolutely crazy. I can't really remember a draft night where, like, a lot of things happened. I know, obviously, the big trade, I think, last year. Was it last year? No, it was a couple years ago, obviously, with Zach LaVine and Jimmy Butler. That was a big one. And then some smaller ones, obviously, with, like the draft trade picks with the Sixers, Lakers, and Celtics when they traded all their drafts together. And then, obviously, the one pretty recently with Luka and Trey. Those was a pretty crazy one. I bet Lennox fans are punching the air right now, but I'm super excited. Also, in recent trade rumor sort of news, is Russell Westbrook has apparently been eyed by the Knicks and the LA Clippers. We could be seeing a crazy trade offer to the Rockets by the Knicks or the Clippers for Russell Westbrook. I think, yo, if the Knicks offered, like, RJ, Kevin Knox, and, like, maybe Mitchell Robinson, maybe you throw in, like, a contract player just to balance everything out for Russell Westbrook. Do Rockets fans say no? Let me know down in the comments, because you're trying to build a team. You're trying to, like, do regular NBA basketball. Obviously, Russell Westbrook is an amazing player. Is it a perfect fit for James Harden? I think the perfect fit for James Harden is to have a really good team around him, and then maybe a really good player. You know, you don't need an MVP, obviously, like Russell Westbrook, but you just need a really good, like, go-to team. And you could have, like, RJ at the one. You have James Harden, Kevin Knox, and Mitchell at the five. You just need to find a four, which is obviously PJ Tucker. You have Rocco still. You have Eric Gordon still. Austin Rivers still. That's not a bad team. That's not a bad team at all. And then the Knicks get their man. They get finally their star that they've been waiting years and years and years for since Melo left. That'd definitely be crazy. That's just a trade I made up on the top of my head. But maybe that's too much. Maybe it'd be more like Mitchell Robinson and like Kevin Knox, or maybe Mitchell Robinson and RJ. Maybe one of them. You're probably going to get all three, but that'd definitely be interesting. And then obviously with the Clippers. Bro, do you think that the Clippers would trade Paul George after their first season, basically half season, with the whole shutdown for Russell Westbrook? Do you think they would do that? You'd have James Harden and Paul George together on a team. That's pretty deadly. I think that's definitely, in my opinion, that's a better duo. Well, a better duo fit than Harden and Westbrook. That's tough. I think I really like that switch. I think Kawhi and Paul George just play too similar. They're both defensive wings who can score the ball. And I think maybe actually splitting them up would be better. Maybe. Obviously, if they didn't, they're still going to be a title favorite. They're still going to be amazing. So obviously, if you can get a trade maybe for Westbrook for Paul George, I'm not really sure how their contracts match up. But if they're eyeing him without, you know, having to really do anything, just a straight-up trade, I think both teams would do it. Now, if the Clippers are trying to get Westbrook without trading Paul George or Kawhi, they're bugging. That's crazy. I don't think the Rockets would do that. Just on a competitive standpoint, you're building a super team for an enemy team that maybe you see yourselves as eye level with. Obviously, with James Harden and Russell Westbrook, that's a great team. Just giving that away would be terrible. So, there's so much trade talks going on, and it just makes me so excited. Next week is the NBA draft. I will be posting a mock draft video about 2 or 3 days before the draft. I'll obviously I need to make it like a relevant video for YouTube, you know, gonna get that suggested video sort of pushed by YouTube, so hopefully you guys are gonna be excited about that. I have some other basketball ideas going on. I have obviously planned on playing the new Call of Duty game, so if you guys want to see Call of Duty gameplay, zombie gameplay, all that stuff, I will be doing that. So for all you gameplay guys, I have not forgotten about you. It's been a while since new games have dropped, so that'd be fun. So hopefully you guys enjoy this video, and I'll see you in my next video very, 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 very soon. All right, guys, bye.